Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you ground wave propagation. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many points that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of ground wave propagation. After that, I'll explain you effect of ground in ground wave propagation. After that, I'll explain you how bending of EM wave happens in ground wave propagation. After that, I'll explain you polarization of EM wave in ground wave propagation. And at last, I'll be discussing about applications of ground wave propagation. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of ground wave propagation. In ground wave propagation, EM waves are guided along the surface of Earth. That's why ground wave propagation is also known as surface wave propagation. If you observe, here we have transmitting antenna and here we have receiving antenna. This is curvature of Earth. In EM wave propagation, here these EM waves are guided along the surface of Earth. That's why ground wave propagation is also known as surface wave propagation. During propagation of EM wave in ground wave, you will be observing there will be bending of EM wave. So that bending of EM wave that happens with respect to surface of Earth. Here in ground wave propagation, transmitting and receiving antenna is placed close to the Earth surface. Here you can observe this is transmitting antenna and this is receiving antenna. With ground wave propagation, EM waves are guided along the surface of Earth. That's why you don't need to keep these antennas at higher height. Here these antennas are placed close to the Earth surface. In ground wave propagation, we will be transmitting vertically polarized signal using vertically polarized antenna. See, in ground wave propagation, we will be transmitting vertically polarized signal. The reason is, here with Earth surface, there will be higher attenuation of signal with horizontal components of electric field, as Earth is having its own magnetic field. So as if you transmit signal in ground wave propagation, then you will have to transmit vertically polarized signal, right? So here we will be using vertically polarized antenna. And ground wave propagation, that we keep it up to 2 MHz of frequency only, and majority of applications are there below 2 MHz of frequency only with ground wave propagation. Now I'll explain you these points with more clarity. So first of all, I'll be explaining you effect of ground in ground wave propagation. In ground wave propagation, Earth is acting like a perfect conductor, because of which it generates exact replica of EM wave inside Earth. Let me explain you how. Here you can observe this is transmitting antenna and here we have curvature of Earth. This Earth surface, that is acting like a perfect conductor, because of which it will be generating perfect replica of EM wave inside Earth surface. Here if you observe, this blue color EM wave that is transmitted by antenna over here, then because of this Earth is acting like a perfect conductor, inside Earth there will be exact replica, and that replica can be observed over here. As and when you have higher potential over here, at a time there will be lower potential over here with this EM wave. And as and when you have lower potential over here, at that time there will be higher potential over here with this EM wave inside this Earth. Right. Now, if you observe, see this propagation that is happening with respect to perfect conductor over here. And as signal is propagated over here, its strength will decrease. And that strength will decrease because of leaky capacitor that is getting generated over here. And as if I say this capacitor is having capacitance value C, then impedance due to that leaky capacitor will be 1 divided by 2 pi fc. Here, if you keep frequency to be higher, in that case, value of xc that will decrease. If xc value is decreasing over here, then this EM wave that is getting shorted inside this Earth. So for a longer distance propagation, this xc value that should be higher, And to keep Xc value higher, we need to keep frequency to be lower, right? So ground wave propagation that is suitable for lower frequency range, we can use ground wave propagation up to 2 MHz of frequency, right? So with AM broadcasting, usually we use ground wave propagation in which we can transmit signal up to few thousands of kilometers, right? Like as if you talk about AM broadcasting in China, then at some times in India also we can receive AM signal of China. The reason is ground wave propagation can go up to few thousands of kilometers, right? Now I'll explain you next point, that is bending of EM waves in ground wave propagation. In ground wave propagation, electromagnetic waves are guided along the Earth surface, and that is possible only if there is a bending of EM waves. If you observe, here we have transmitting antenna that is situated at Pakistan, and here we have receiving antenna that is situated at China. In ground wave propagation, this EM wave that is traveling along the Earth surface, so here there will be significant bending you can observe. And this EM wave bending is happening because of refraction and diffraction of EM waves. And this bending of EM wave is significant at longer wavelength. So one should know wavelength, that is lambda is equals to C by F. So for significant bending, wavelength should be longer. And if you have longer wavelength, then frequency will be lower over here, right? So here, ground wave propagation, that is limited by frequency up to 2 MHz, right? So ground wave propagation is happening because of bending of EM waves, and bending is happening because of refraction and diffraction, right? And that is possible at longer wavelengths only. That's why with ground wave propagation, we keep frequency up to 2 MHz only. And with ground wave propagation, one should know communication is possible up to 1000 miles, or one can say up to 1600 kilometers, right? Now I'll explain you next point, that is polarization of EM wave in ground wave propagation. In ground wave propagation, we transmit vertically polarized signal. Polarization means orientation of electric field. So as and when we transmit ground wave signal, at that time polarization will be vertical polarization. If you observe, here we have direction of propagation and electric field is oscillating vertically. Orientation of electric field is polarization. So as electric field is oscillating vertically, you can say this signal is vertically polarized signal. In ground wave propagation, we should be transmitting vertically polarized signal. The reason is horizontal component of electric field is having higher attenuation due to Earth. The reason is in ground wave propagation, Earth is acting like a perfect conductor. So if you have horizontal component of electric field, then that is getting absorbed immediately by this Earth. That's why we need to transmit vertically polarized signal in ground wave propagation. Now I'll be discussing about applications of ground wave propagation. See, ground wave propagation, that is limited to 2 MHz of frequency, and this ground wave propagation that is broadly used with local radio broadcasting, where frequency is ranging from 535 kHz to 1605 kHz. You can observe here, we have AM radio in which frequency is ranging from 535 kHz to 1605 kHz. Here we use ground wave propagation with some other applications also, like we can use it with ground wave radar, as well as for radio navigation, we use ground wave propagation. So there are some other applications even, but I have listed few applications only which are majorly used with ground wave propagation. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.